Are you aware of the levels of radon gas that are in your home? If not, you probably should be. I'll admit that up until recently, I wasn't aware of the serious health implications that exposure to high levels of radon can pose, including lung cancer. But when my in-laws got their house tested and found that it had high levels of radon, I did a little bit more research, which I'm going to share with you in today's important video. So first off, what is radon? Well, it's a colourless, odourless, radioactive gas that forms when radioactive materials break down over time in groundwater, rocks, or soil. Now, this gas can enter buildings through their foundations and it gets trapped there. Now, this is important because inhaling high levels of radon gas over a long period of time can significantly increase your chances of developing lung cancer. In fact, it's estimated that about 20,000 people die of radon-related lung cancer every year in America, making it the second leading cause of lung cancer deaths after smoking cigarettes. Yes, you heard that right. The second leading cause of lung cancer deaths after smoking cigarettes. Now, this to me was absolutely shocking. Now, you're probably wondering, do I have a radon risk in my own home that I don't know about? Well, the prevalence of radon varies depending on the type of soil and rock in the area. Now, the UK Health and Security Agency has created an interactive map that shows the highest rates of radon across the country, and I put a link to this in the description box below to help. Now, in the US, the Environmental Protection Agency, or EPA, estimates that one in every 15 American homes has dangerously high levels of radon. Now, radon levels tend to be highest in homes that are located in the northern, midwestern, as well as northeastern regions of the United States. Now, this is primarily due to underlying geology of these areas, but it's important to note that high radon levels can be found in homes across the country, not just in these regions. Now, the EPA has a map showing radon zones across the US, which can be a helpful resource. The map that you're seeing on screen now is an example of this, and the areas in red are the areas with the highest levels. But it's important to remember radon levels can vary greatly even within the same neighborhood. So the only real way to know is by testing your home, which we'll cover later on in this video. It's also worth knowing that you're more likely to encounter high levels of radon gas in basements or buildings that are not well ventilated. So how would you know if you've been exposed to radon? Well, unfortunately, there is no way to test someone for radon exposure, and there are no immediate signs or symptoms to indicate that you've been exposed to this radioactive gas. However, if you've had repeated exposure over a prolonged period, so say 20 or 30 years, then you do have an increased risk of developing lung cancer, especially if you're also a smoker. Now, symptoms of lung cancer can include chest pain, prolonged shortness of breath, a persistent cough that doesn't go away after 3 weeks, coughing up blood, difficulty breathing or swallowing, feeling very tired, as well as unexplained weight loss. Now, if you do have any of these symptoms, I would advise that you should go and see your doctor. So how do you actually test for radon? Well, whilst you can't get tested for radon exposure, you can test your home for high levels of radon. There are two main ways to do this. You can either hire a professional to test your home, or there are self-test kits that you can purchase at most hardware or home improvement stores. And I've also included some links to these in the description box of the video where you can purchase them from Amazon directly. Now, if you test your home and you find high levels of radon, there are some simple steps that you can take to significantly reduce your exposure, which will ultimately hopefully decrease your chances of developing lung cancer. Now, some of these steps include improving your home's ventilation, and you can do this by opening windows or using fans, fixing cracks in the foundation, as well as putting up plastic sheets in homes with crawl spaces. Now, if high levels of radon are detected, mitigation systems can be professionally installed, which is obviously very good news. Now, these systems can reduce radon levels by up to 99%. The other good news is that new buildings can incorporate radon-resistant construction techniques to prevent radon entry in the first place. Finally, it's advisable to retest your home every couple of years or after you've made significant home renovation improvements. I hope that you found this video helpful, and hopefully you've learned something new that could prevent you or your family from getting lung cancer. Please remember to check out the description box of this video for more information on this topic from trusted websites, and please do share any comments or questions in the comments section below.